OpenAI is about to integrate GPT-4 into Bing. Microsoft's integration of OpenAI's latest generation of GPT language models is reportedly scheduled to happen within just a few weeks. As part of Microsoft's recent announcement of a multi-billion-dollar investment, GPT-4 and other AI models are expected to be integrated into Microsoft's consumer and enterprise products and accessible through Azure Cloud. Prior to the announcement, there were rumors that Microsoft was seeking to enhance Bing search with ChatGPT or a similar model. However, according to sources familiar with the product and launch plans, the model in question is not ChatGPT, but is instead the highly anticipated GPT-4. This new model is expected to provide quicker and more human-like responses with greater detail compared to ChatGPT, which seems probable as a speedier model would be ideal for use in a search engine. This means it's possible that Microsoft may use a smaller version of the model. Furthermore, they may have applied optimizations to GPT-4, such as sparse modeling, and increased the amount of training data while controlling the model size. In addition to this, OpenAI is also seemingly planning to launch a ChatGPT app for smartphones, indicating the company's entry into the lucrative mobile market. Moreover, it's believed that OpenAI is working on a new feature for DALL-E to also enable AI-generated videos, but it's unclear whether this will be a generative AI video model to compete with Google's Imagen, or if it will just be an AI video editor. Recently, Sam Altman played down the projections for GPT-4, dampening the expectation of a 100 trillion parameter model, instead indicating that GPT-4 would be characterized by its efficiency and data quality rather than its parameter count, making Microsoft's intended use for its search engine appear to be a good fit. With the release reportedly just a few weeks away, the company could launch a high-quality chatbot search engine ahead of Google's planned release of Sparrow. Furthermore, on top of a recent upgrade to ChatGPT for increased actuality and math skills, the company has also developed an AI-generated text classifier to identify text generated by OpenAI models, plus other AI language models too. But there are limitations to its reliability. The classifier is supposed to differentiate between AI-generated and human-written text, but OpenAI acknowledges that it's not fully reliable. In testing a set of English texts, their classifier correctly classified 26% of texts written by ChatGPT as likely written by AI, but misclassified 9% of human-written texts as being AI-generated. The performance of the classifier decreases as the size of the generating language model increases, meaning that larger models are more capable of generating human-like texts without detectable patterns. The classifier has not yet been evaluated on student writings, automated disinformation campaigns, or chat transcripts. Additionally, the classifier's performance has not been tested on texts co-authored by AI and humans, which is likely a common use case for artificial intelligence text processing. The company acknowledges that AI-generated text can easily be edited to evade the classifier, and it is unclear whether artificial intelligence text recognition will provide a long-term advantage. Other search engines are also joining the AI chatbot race, as China's leading search engine, which is called Baidu, is also preparing to launch an AI chatbot service similar to OpenAI's ChatGPT, according to an anonymous source. This could be China's significant contribution to the technology race, as it's rumored that they intend to integrate their ChatGPT competitor into their primary search services in March. On top of OpenAI's advances in natural language processing, Nvidia has just revealed its new language-directed AI model for video games called PADL, which is a framework that trains language-directed controllers for physics-based character animation using reinforcement learning. While these models can produce realistic motions, they usually have a limited control interface. With PADL, Nvidia aimed to create a more versatile interface by utilizing natural language to decompose a character's behaviors into tasks and skills. The tasks represent high-level objectives, such as reaching a target, and the skills represent the low-level actions, such as walking or running, used to achieve the task. The framework has three stages: skill embedding, where a shared space for text and motion data is learned from a dataset of clips and captions; policy training, where reinforcement learning policies are trained on the skill embedding for specific tasks and imitate skills from the motion dataset; and multitask control, where multiple policies are combined to handle various tasks and skills. The motion and language encoders map clips and captions to a shared embedding space, while a motion decoder reconstructs the original clip. The control policies are trained to perform skills using natural language commands and can adapt to new commands not seen in the training data. Additionally, they can be trained to perform different high-level tasks. The development of systems that can create natural and lifelike movements for simulated characters has been a focus in computer animation for a long time. But for these systems to be practical, they need to not only generate high-quality movements, but also offer a user-friendly and flexible interface to control a character's actions. Natural language provides an easy and accurate way to express a user's intentions, and advances in natural language processing have shown the effectiveness of language-based interfaces for various applications such as image generation and program synthesis. PADL allows users to issue natural language commands to specify both high-level tasks and low-level skills for a character to perform. It uses an adversarial imitation learning method to train policies that map language commands to low-level controls for the character to complete the desired task. PADL also implements a multitask aggregation method that uses a language-based multiple-choice question-answering approach to determine high-level objectives from language commands. The framework's effectiveness is demonstrated by directing a simulated humanoid character to perform a wide range of complex motor skills. It is important to use an adaptive schedule to balance different objectives in the training process, as task weight can affect the performance of the character, as directing the character to perform incompatible or unconventional skills can lead to unnatural behaviors. In another leap into the future, wearable robotics devices have leveled up as a result of GZI bodies for digital cyborgs and their research. Over 50 years after the idea of a cyborg was first introduced, GZI has created a wearable base unit that includes up to 6 detachable robotic arms controlled by the user, designed to facilitate social interaction between multiple wearers and investigate potential interactions in a cyborg society. The concept of a GZI body is proposed with the aim of enabling individuals to live according to their own desires in society by utilizing a combination of robotics, machine learning, wearable technology, and teleexistence to advance body editing. By acquiring a GZI body, one has the ability to control both their natural body and its extensions, both in the physical and digital world. The details of the GZI body and its associated state have been outlined in various papers by related research groups, with even literature reviews being provided that focus on various fields such as human augmentation, robotics and virtual reality, neuro and cognitive sciences, and the humanities, which are crucial for understanding and designing the GZI body, and the 5 key elements of a wearable robotics device are highlighted through their existing works. Finally, example scenarios are presented to demonstrate what a society with GZI body could look like, with the aim being to present it as a desirable state for the development and design of augmented humans and step towards a multifunctional transhumanist society.